गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आवर लास्ट टॉपिक इन द सेक्शन 4 इज़ द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ हिल्बर्ट टाइप सिंगुलर इंटीग्रल इक्वेशंस। सो टुडे वी विल सॉल्व द हिल्बर्ट सिंगुलर इंटीग्रल इक्वेशन ऑफ सेकेंड काइंड विच इज़ गिवन बाय a इंटू जी इज इक्वल टू एफ माइनस बी अपॉन 2 पाई इंटीग्रल 0 टू स्टार्ट 2 पाई जी टी cot of t minus s by 2 dt. In this integral equation, a and b, these are two complex constants. In order to solve this integral equation, let us define two operators. First operator, we define the operator L, which is defined by L operated on the function g is equal to a into g plus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi gt cot of t minus s by 2 dt. Now, from the first equation, we can see that the value of function f is given by a into g plus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi gt cot of t minus s by 2 dt. So, the equation 2 becomes L operated on function g is equal to f. Now, let us define another operator, which is defined by the operator M. This is called adjoint operator. M operated on a function phi. This is defined by a into phi minus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi phi cot of t minus s by 2 dt. Now, from the equation 3, operating both sides by the operator M, the third equation becomes M operated on LG is equal to M operated on the function f. Now, we can substitute the values of LG from the equation 2nd. Here, this equation will become M operated on a into g plus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi gt cot of t minus s by 2 dt. And on the right side, we have m operated on the function f. Now, let us take the expression inside the brackets as the function y. So, the equation will become m operated on y is equal to fs, mf. So, simplifying the expression, we get a into y minus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi yt cot of t minus s by 2 dt is equal to, on the right side, we have the value of mf. M operated on f, that gives us the value a into f minus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi f into cot of t minus s by 2 dt. Now, let us denote a into fs minus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi fs cot of t minus s by 2 dt by the function capital F. So, using this notation in the integral equation 7, the equation becomes a into y minus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi yt cot of t minus s by 2 dt is equal to capital Fs. Now, substituting the values of ys and yt from the equation 6 here, the value of function ys, that is a into g plus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi gt cot of t minus s by 2. And also here, we have substituted the value of yt. The value of yt is again obtained from the value of ys by replacing s by t, and we have replaced t by sigma. So, value of yt from here becomes a into gt plus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi g sigma cot of sigma minus t by 2 d sigma. So substituting the value of ys and yt, we get finally this equation in which right hand side is the function f. Now multiplying the terms a into a, this will become a square into gs plus a into b divided by 2 pi integral 0 to star 2 pi gt cot of t minus s by 2 dt. Here multiplying the terms, this will become minus ab by 2 pi integral 0 to star 2 pi gt cot of t minus s by 2 dt. Multiplying these two terms, we get minus b square upon 4 pi square integral 0 to star 2 pi cot of t minus s by 2 into integral 0 to star 2 pi g sigma cot of sigma minus t by 2 d sigma. This integral is with respect to t. And on the right side, we have the function capital F. Now these two terms are cancelled out. So finally, this equation becomes a square into g minus b square upon 4 pi square integral 0 to star 2 pi cot of t minus s by 2 dt into the integral 0 to star 2 pi g sigma cot of sigma minus t by 2 d sigma. And on the right side, we have f. Now, we can use Hilbert formula, which we derived in the previous lecture. Now, this expression here, the value of this expression, that is given by using Hilbert formula, which is the value minus gs plus 1 upon 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi g sigma d sigma. So, substituting the value of the expression from Hilbert formula, the previous integral equation becomes a square into g minus b square into minus g plus 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi g sigma d sigma is equal to fs. Now let us combine the terms with the function g. These two terms we have combined. So this will become a square plus g square b square into g minus b square upon 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi g sigma d sigma is equal to f. From here, we can find the value of g dividing throughout by a square plus b square. So we get the value of g, which is given by f divided by a square plus b square plus b square upon 2 pi a square plus b square into integral 0 to 2 pi g sigma d sigma. Now let us replace sigma by the variable t. So we get an equation which is the Fredholm integral equation of second kind with separable kernels. Now let us solve this integral equation by the algebraic method which we used in the section 1 to solve Fredholm integral equations of second kind. So let us denote this term by c. So this equation will become g is equal to f upon a square plus b square plus b square c divided by 2 pi into a square plus b square. Now let us find the value of c. Now c is integral 0 to 2 pi gt dt. Now substituting the value of gt from here by replacing s by t, we get the value of gt, which is given by ft upon a square plus b square upon 2 pi into a square plus b square into integral 0 to 2 pi gt dt. This is c. So substituting the value here, we get the expression integral 0 to 2 pi ft upon a square plus b square dt plus b square c upon 2 pi c, 2 pi into a square plus b square into the t between the limits 0 to 2 pi. On the right side, we have c. Now this will become 2 pi, which is cancelled with 2 pi. So we get the value of c is equal to integral 0 to 2 pi f upon a square plus b square into dt plus b square c divided by a square plus b square. Now let us combine these two terms on one side of this equation. So we get the value of c from here, which is given by 1 upon a square into integral 0 to 2 pi ft dt. Now the value of capital Ft can be obtained from the equation in which we have defined the function f. So from there we have the value of capital Ft, which is a into small ft. So substituting the value here, finally we get the value of c, which is given by 1 upon a into integral 0 to 2 pi ft dt. Now let us substitute the value c in the equation number 7. So the equation becomes gs is equal to fs upon a square plus b square plus b square upon 2 pi a square plus b square into 1 upon a into integral 0 to 2 pi ft dt. Now let us substitute the value of capital F here in this equation. So finally we get g is equal to 1 upon a square plus b square, and here we have substituted the value of capital F is, which is a into small f minus b upon 2 pi integral 0 to start 2 pi ft cot of t minus s pi 2 dt. And this term we have taken as it is. So from here we get the value of g, which is the solution of Hilbert type singular integral equation of second kind. And this is given by g is equal to a into fs divided by a square plus b square minus b upon 2 pi into a square plus b square into integral 0 to start 2 pi ft cot of t minus s pi 2 dt plus b square upon 2 pi a square plus b square into integral 0 to 2 pi ft dt. So this completes the solution of second kind Hilbert integral equation.